Hello, friends. You're the Lonesome Gamer, and tonight I'm playing Archipelago. It's a pretty new game by Ludicoly. Well, that's at least the European publisher. I don't know the American one. And it's a game about colonization. You will explore the archipelago. You will trade with the inhabitants. You will build buildings and cities. But you also have to take care of the requirements of the inhabitants of the archipelago, and there will be also demands of the motherland of the colony. So you have to keep a balance between your own interests and the interests of the motherland and the colony. It's a semi-cooperative game, and the goal is different. You have I think two goals that everybody knows, and they change each game. They're determined by cards, and then every player has a secret goal, and there are also different different ways to end this game. There's some condition, and if this condition happens, the game will end. And if you manage to come to this condition without a rebellion on the archipelago, then you all win this game. But if a rebellion occurs because there are too many people which are not happy, basically, then then you all lose the game. And if you all win the game, then you take a look at the secret goals and you see who is the big winner. And this concept actually led to a lot of controversial reviews. The basic problem is that if someone sees that he cannot win this game anymore, and if he's not a nice person, then he might actually try to destroy the game for everybody, so making everybody a loser. And that is possible. He can force this rebellion to happen. And if you're playing with these kind of guys, this is definitely not the right game. So there are many people who say they don't like this game, they don't like this concept of these secret goals. But I'm a lonesome gamer, so first of all, I could argue I decide which character my imaginary opponents have, but in this case, it's even better because the game also has a solitaire expansion. It's this one. And there you don't have these problems at all. So, let's set up the game. Okay, the game is set. We have here a pile of archipelago tiles. These are some cards. They end up up here. These are called exploration markers. And up here, we have here the local market with the different goods. We have the foreign market, which shows the trading with the motherland. Here we have our population, and it shows the, well, the happy people and the rebels, or the unhappy people. And here we have the unemployed people. We start here with one good of each at the local market. We have here fish, then these fruits. We have cattle, stone, wood, and iron. This is, well, we can call this, I don't know, the action board, maybe. That's where we place our action tokens as a reminder what we have done during this turn. Here we have some resources, a little player aid, our markers, meeples, we have ships, our money, this is the bank, these are the buildings, and this is the starting tile with a ship of ours. So as you can see here, this is the solitaire expansion, and it comes with lots of scenarios. And we have here short scenarios, I think about 7 short scenarios, and they will take you maybe, I don't know, hard to say, maybe 20 minutes or something like that if you are an advanced player. For me it takes maybe half an hour or so. Then we have these scenarios here of a middle length, about 12 I think, and well, there may be 3/4 of an hour or something like this. And here we have about 10 or so long scenarios. And well, I don't know how long they are. Let's see. I've chosen to take one of these long scenarios. I randomly took Baron Stevie Job. This is this guy, work for hire. And we see now here the starting conditions. We start here on this tile, as you can see here. We start with one ship, 2 meeples, so these are our people here, these guys, and 10 bucks. It's called florine in this game, the money. These are the victory or the ending conditions. The game is over. Well, of course, if there's a rebellion, then we've lost instantly. Or if we made it through all 3 of these exploration tokens, of all 3 piles, each one with 8 tokens. So we have to explore 24 tiles. And this is then the result. And normally these scenarios are really tough. I mean, it's possible to do this bronze result here. So in this case, you can say, okay, I won this thing. Because you only lose if there's a rebellion. So if you avoid the rebellion, you've won. but to do it with a silver or gold award, it's really hard. I mean, in some scenarios I've read that it's nearly impossible. But let's see. Okay, and before I start this game, I just want to tell you, I'm a beginner in this game. I'm not a good Euro player at all. So I might make some strange decisions and, well, maybe I don't play very effective. And I'm not going so much for these great goals here. I just try to prevent the rebellion, and I'm happy if I make it to the end of the game. Okay, so now let's see the game. A game turn has 6 phases. First one is deactivation of your people. That doesn't happen in the first turn. The second one is the player order. In the multiplayer game, you do this by bidding. But in the solitaire play, this step won't happen at all. The third one is then, well, the effects of these inhabitants, tables, and the market tables, depending on how many resources there are and on how many unemployed people there are, there will be unhappy citizens or rebels, and in this phase we have to adjust that stuff. But in the first turn this won't happen too. And then it's the balance on the archipelago, and that is also something that doesn't happen during the first turn. So the first thing that happens actually is the action phase. At the beginning of the game, you can take 3 actions. These are my action markers. And I can place them here on this board. And I will go a little more into the light here. And basically, well, let's see, I can show you what actions you can do. First, you can gain resources. You can harvest resources. There are 6 resources, as I said before: fish, food or fruits, wood, iron, stone, and cattle. Then you can build any building, city, or ship. That's another action you can do. You can trade. That's the third possible action. You can trade with a local market or with a foreign market. This is migration. That simply means you can move your ships or your people on the archipelago. Here we have reproduction. So if there are 2 meeples on a tile, you can add a 3rd one. These are taxes. You can hire people. That's another action you can do. And finally, here in the middle, we have 2 options, 2 special options of trading with the foreign market here, that's the harbor, or with the local market, that's here, the market. And I will explain later what the difference between these special options and this trading action here is. And I forgot, you can explore. This is this option down here. And you can see here, some of these actions have these colored circles. And that means if I've placed my action marker on my color, I cannot do this a second time during this turn. Here in the other actions it doesn't matter. You can place your action markers or as many action markers as you want here. But not here with these colored circles. Then we have some actions like that one or like this one. They have these multicolored circles. So in this case here, let's say exploring, I can always do one action, place one here, and then, and that's especially important for the multiplayer game, two people could do an additional exploring action. In the solitaire game, I can actually do three exploring actions because I can simply place my other action markers on these multicolored spaces. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna take one of these action markers and do an exploration action. So I place it there and now I have to decide. I can either take this tile, I can look at it obviously and I can decide if I want to take that one or if I want to take the one underneath without looking at it. So right now I think I will take this one because it fits fine. It has to fit to the tile where you explore from. So in this case it's a good thing. I take that one. Let's see. Okay, perfect. So we can place this tile somewhere here. And now there's also a backside here. And we could also decide to take the backside and place it here somewhere. And in this case it looks actually better. Maybe I will use that side. Okay, yeah, as a matter of fact, I will do this simply because I mean, it's not so easy to decide. The advantage of this is there are two resources here. Here, on the other hand, I can start with two islands, which is an advantage for further exploration, I guess. So, right now I'm not so sure what to do, actually. Okay, actually I think I'm gonna take this side. And just want you to notice this wonderful artwork here. There's so much detail on these tiles. You can see a shipwreck here. You see the birds here. You even see the shadow of the bird here. So that's really great artwork. And now we place it somewhere here. Somehow like this, I think. Okay, perfect. And we move our ship on this tile as part of the exploration action. Now, what happens is, that's an exploration effect. First of all, we are allowed to take one of these exploration counters. And first of all, they bring us closer to an end. Second of all, every time when one of these piles is completely gone, I will get another action marker. So if I explored 8 tiles, then the first pile will be empty, and then I will have a 4th action marker that I can use every turn. So that's a big advantage. In addition, these exploration markers look like this from one side, like that from the other side. They're kind of a wild card if I have to pay resources. This is one resource of any kind. I can just spend it like a normal resource. Okay. Furthermore, another effect of the exploration is there are these little huts here. You can see them. In this case, there are 4 huts on this tile. Okay, sorry for the interruption. So I was exploring this tile and I took this exploration marker. And now, as I said, we have these 4 huts here. And this is the number of inhabitants on this tile. So now we're gonna place 4 unemployed people here on this table. The next thing that happens, we can add 1 resource to the local market. In this case, there's only 1 resource. This is this fruit. That's the green cube, and we place that here at the local market. And you can see here on the left is the price. The more resources there are, the lower the price is. If there was now a second resource, I could take it for myself. So in this case, it's a disadvantage that I explored a tile with just 1 resource, but the topography here kind of seemed to be better for me than this isolated island. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to take my 2 meeples and I'm gonna place 1 here and the other 1 here. Okay, so that was my first action. And now I do a second exploration action. So I'm gonna place another one of these action markers here on a multicolored exploration space. And I think, I'm not absolutely sure, but I think I can use my ship to do a second exploration. I'm not absolutely sure about that, but I think it should be possible. So what I do now is I take this next tile, and I think that looks quite okay. So I simply take it and I place the next one then up here like this. And if you explore, you have to place the new tile obviously in a way. Wait a minute, I can take a look at the other side. Well, that's a desert. That's definitely not interesting. So I'm going to use that tile, that side. If you explore, you can use... you have to place the tile in a way that it fits with the landscape to the other tiles. And normally it has to touch 2 other tiles. So like this. There is one exception. You can add a new tile on your starting tile, and it doesn't have to touch another tile. So I could also place that, for example, here, if I'd like to. But in this, well, in general, but there's an additional requirement. It has to be also always next to one of my ships or meeples. So in this case, I cannot place it here because my ship is there and not here. So I will place it like this. I think that's okay. And then I'm allowed to draw my next exploration marker. I will move, well, I think I will move the ship here. And this time I can take, I can place one of these resources on the local market, and that will be the cattle. So I place them here. And now I'm allowed to take a second resource. That's the fish in this case. And I can take this for myself. There is one hut here. So we now have one unemployed worker in addition. And I forgot that actually we have here now two people on our archipelago. So what we got to do now is we place this white meeple here on a two. This is the total number of people, of inhabitants of our archipelago. So and now I got one action left after my two exploration actions. And this time I'm going to do this reproduction. Place that here. I can only do this once per turn. And now every tile with exactly two meeples on it produces one additional meeple. So in this case it's only this tile, and I can place another one here, and I think I'm wondering on which side I should place them, because they cannot, normally they cannot cross this the sea here. I hope they still they're still able to reproduce, but I think it's possible. I think it just says there has to be two people on a tile. They don't have to be on the same side of an island, I think. I think I'm going to place it actually, well, probably here. Not sure if that was so clever, but we will see about that later. There's another rule. There'll never be allowed more than three meeples of the same color on an island. Or on a tile, actually, on a tile. So that's now the maximum. I have to move away with one if I want to do another reproduction here. So now we've done our three actions. And we come to the next phase, and that means we have to buy these, we have to buy one of these cards. And as you can see here, we have here five cards. Well, it's a little bad with the light here, but if we go closer you can see that. So normally you have to either buy a card and turn another card. I will explain later what that means. Or you can turn two cards. If you play solitaire, you have to buy one card and turn two additional cards. That's a special rule. If you're not able to buy a card because you can't afford it, you lose the game instantly. So right now, I think I'm gonna buy this one. That's basically education. And it costs now, if it's like this, you see this red arrow here, that shows the price. Okay? And I buy this and that costs me 3 florin. And the effect is, I can use this card once per turn. And I can reduce the unemployed people. That's here. This guy is an unemployed person. And I can reduce the number of them by 2. And that's the perfect card for that scenario. Because my goal is to have as little unemployed people as possible. So, but I didn't cheat here. I swear that was lying there from the beginning. I was just really lucky here. So now I have to pay 3. And this is a 5 and this is 3. So that is, oh, that's 1, the silver ones, and these are 5 florin. So I pay 3 and then I have to turn 2 more cards. And I will turn the Admiral. It says you can move your ships up to 3 regions. But I think that's not so important now. So I will turn this guy. And now the price changes. Normally he costs 3 at the beginning. And if you turn them, and you always have to turn them clockwise, now he costs 4. And then we got the king here. He gives you 1 victory point. And then it says here, when bidding for the player order, you have an additional bonus of 3 florin. But in our case, in the solitaire game, this has no use at all. Only the victory point. There are scenarios where you need victory points. So in this case, it would be good, but not in our scenario. So I can simply turn this guy and, well, we're done here. Okay, so that was now phase 6. And that's the end of the first turn. Okay, and now it's the second turn, and we go through our turn order again. The first would be deactivation. But in this case, there is no one activated. So we don't have to deactivate anyone. The next thing is, again, the turn order, which is not which does not happen here. And now it's the effects of the inhabitants. And we now see here, on the market, depending on how many goods are on the market, that will have effect on the inhabitants. If there are more goods on the market, then there will be unemployed people, because you don't need that much workers to gain these goods. And if there are even more goods on the market, then there will be rebels. You can see that here. This is an unemployed person, and these are rebels. But right now, there are not so many goods on the market, so there is no problem with that. The same with the foreign market. There are no goods at all. And now we see this. And this is, as I said, the population, the total of the population. And I forgot that there is a third one now. So we have now 3 people living on the archipelago. And the more people there are, there will be also then unemployed persons or rebels. But up to 10 people, it's absolutely no problem. And here, this is the number of unemployed persons. And you can see here, if there are just 3, then 1 rebel goes away, actually. And if there are 8 or more, then we have to add now 1 rebel. But again, this time with 5 persons, it stays the same. So there are no special effects. Otherwise, we had to place this black guy. He stands for the rebels. We have to place him here to mark how many rebels are on the archipelago. If there are ever more rebels than normal people on the board, then there is a rebellion and the game is lost. Okay. So, but until now it's all fine. And now it's number 4, balance on the archipelago. And, oh, sorry people, I forgot something. There's a lot to think about that. At the end of phase 6, when I bought this card, I had to replace that card. So I take the topmost card here, and I simply place it here. And that's perfect. That's another great card for the scenario. This is a minister for employment, I would say. And you can activate this guy to reduce the number of unemployed people. So that's just great again for our scenario. It's really looking good. Okay, anyway, so now we're again here in phase 4, balance on the archipelago. What we do now is we take a look at the topmost card here. We start here with the upper, half, and now these are the demands on the local market. The demands of the inhabitants of the archipelago. So they want cattle, and it says for 1 cattle you can feed 4 people. So now there are here 3 people, so we have to spend 1 cattle to make them all happy. We can now spend cattle either from the local market or from our own property. But we only have fish, so, and there is enough cattle here, so no problems. We simply give that away and they're all happy. If we had now a situation where we had not enough cattle, then it could happen that some people would start becoming rebels. But right now that's not the point. This is now the second half here. The lower one is that shows the need of the motherland, the foreign market. So that shows you have to pay 2 fruit from the foreign market or from your own property. And now we have a problem because we don't have any fruit here, and we also don't have any fruit here. What we can do is we can use one of these exploration tokens. Remember I said you can use them as wild resources, and I'm gonna do this now. I'm gonna spend one of these tokens and now there is
one left that we have to pay.
But I will not spend my other token. So what happens now is, because there is one left and I cannot pay that, or I will not pay that, we have now one rebel in the archipelago. So we place this black marker here on the first space. Okay. For each cube that you cannot pay here in this phase, you will get an additional rebel here on that table.
So now we come again to the action phase,
and we get back our three action tokens, of course. And I have to think about this now. Okay, so what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna place an action marker here on the exploration space. And now I have to decide, do I want this tile here or the one underneath? And in this case, I cannot place at least this side of the tile. I don't know what the back side is. Maybe I could use the back side here, but I think I will not risk that. So what I'm gonna do is I take the one underneath. So let's see what that is. That doesn't look so good. So this is now discarded. We cannot use this anymore. And let's see what that offers. Well, that's bad. So this one and that one, we cannot place them any... Well, actually, no, it doesn't work. It's... No. So it doesn't fit anywhere. So this exploration action actually did not work. So we simply lose this action. I think I'm gonna try another one. So now I place this one here on this multicolored space. And I can again decide what I wanna do. And I'm not gonna take this tile. I'm gonna take the next one. And that is fine, we can use this. Not exactly perfect because it's pretty isolated, so we cannot place it here, for example, to expand this island, but anyway, so what I'm gonna do now is actually I have to place it here. It's the only option because it has to be adjacent to water, so I cannot explore with my meeples. I can only explore with the boat, and I cannot put it here because the boat is not adjacent to it. It has to be always adjacent to one of my figures. So in this case, I have to place it here, and yeah, fine. I'm going to place it like this. And that's a little sad now because because it's not close to the other islands, I cannot move a meeple there. So, I have to transport them with ships. But anyway, first I can now move here, or I have to move here with my ship, and then I can I give one resource. We have here stones and iron. I give one resource to the local market, And I'm wondering what that might be. Well, actually, it doesn't really matter. I think I take stones.
Place it here.
And then I can take a resource for myself. And in this case, this will be iron. That's the red, that's the black cube. Because I can sell iron for more money than I can sell stones. Here the iron is worth 6. Here also 6 on the local market. The stones are only worth 5 on the local market. You cannot see that, I'm sorry for that, but you can see here a 4, so above there is a 5. And here 4 on the foreign market. So it's the value is a little higher of these of the iron now. Okay. And I get another exploration token. I tend to forget these tokens, and then I have to see, I have to look for inhabitants. We have here a single hut. So we now have here another unemployed worker. Fine. Okay, as my next action, I'm gonna hire a worker. Actually, with one action, I can hire as many workers as I want and as I can afford. But in this case, I can only hire one simply because I have to buy one of these cards in the next phase. Remember, if I cannot do this, the game is lost. So I will pay now 3 here. That's the price for the worker right now. So I pay 3. And now the number of unemployed people is reduced by 1. And I get another inhabitant, another meeple. And I'm allowed to place this guy when there is one of my figures on the same tile. But there is this restriction that there are no more meeples allowed than 3 on a single tile. So it is not possible to place the worker here, but I can place him here because there is my ship. So I place him here on the island, and now I got 4 people on the archipelago, so I have to raise here the number of inhabitants. In addition, now during the action phase, I can also use these cards. And I can use this education card. I simply can turn it like this. And that means now that 2 of these unemployed people go away. So it's 1, 2. So this is now a 3. And the good thing about this now is, in the next turn, when these population effects are done, we can subtract 1 rebel from here. So this guy goes away. That's pretty cool. Okay, and now we have to buy, it's phase number 6, we have to buy a new card. And well, I could either buy this guy here. He's kind of a financial counselor. It says for each 5 florin that you own, you gain an additional florin from the bank. But you have to pay 1 to use this guy. This is indicated up here. That shows that you have to pay one if you use it.
So
This is not so useful right now because I don't have much money. So I think I'm gonna not buy him right now. I'm not sure. It could be a good idea. This is actually the Minister of Agriculture, and he's pretty cool because he allows us to add up to 2 cattle and or fruits from the bank to the local market. So that is pretty good. If there are no cattle or fruits in the local market, and we have to be afraid of the demands of the population, we can add some. But right now in this turn, I think it's also not necessary. So I think actually I could even buy this guy, but I think I will turn this one, the Ministry of Employment, because he becomes cheaper if I turn him now. Still 3, but in the next turn he will be at 2. So that's pretty cool. So I will turn him, and not sure which one to buy. Maybe I will buy this guy or the Admiral with his 3. He's also not bad. I'm wondering if I should buy this financial counselor, because he's really cheap. He only costs me 2. Or if I should buy the Admiral. Because I don't need the King and he's extremely expensive. So let me see. What I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna have to check that. I think, okay, I think I will turn the Admiral. So like this. And I will buy this guy, the financial counselor. Right now I may not need him, but he's really cheap, so might be a good idea. Okay. And then we have to replace his card, and we draw, well, that is a headhunter, and that allows me to take a look at the first 5 cards here, and I can choose one character card. I can buy one character card. The other cards are discarded. So you have these cards here, and then you have these cards, the character cards. And yeah, so I could then choose one of these character cards in this case. But yeah, we'll see later. Now there's another thing that happened. We have now this red colored half up here. Normally you can see, or very often you can see, there are only these yellow colored things, and you have to resolve that during the phase 4 balance of the archipelago. If there is now this red colored half, then this is an actual crisis, and you have to handle this right away. So that means now we have to pay fruit. There is a need of fruit, a demand of fruit on the local market. One fruit is good for 5 people. So in this case, that's not a problem. We have 2 fruit up here, so we can take one and all my four people are happy with that. Okay. So that's it. That was the second turn. And, well, I think, until now I'm doing fine. Just one rebel, not too many unemployed people. The good thing is, for the scenario, I really have great cards. I got this card here, this education. That's absolutely great. That makes it much easier to play. And this Ministry of Labor or whatever. So that's really cool. That could ease the scenario a lot. So I hope this all made a little sense. And as I said, I haven't played this game too much, and it's pretty deep. You have a lot of options, and I'm gonna probably forget something here and there, and maybe I play even something a little wrong, but feel free to correct me. And well, I hope to see you in my next videos. Until then, bye.